You've been right now you've got another little surprise. You've got the chance to choose which room you go into, because, well, you can't choose. You don't know which room it'll be, but here's the keys. One is for the shrieky room, one is for Boris's tower, and the other is for the nightmare room. Inside those rooms there is a task that is worth 2 eyeballs. Because we don't know which one it's going to be, so the choice is yours, Splatty Splatty. Are you going to say now? In, or are you going to go in?
We're going.
You're going to go in?
Yes.
The shrinking room.
Oh, follow me up here to the shrinking room.
Oh, how's it hanging, dudes? This game is all about big heads. All the geezers have to do is place the 8 electro helmets on each of these 8 old has-beens here. So let's move in!
Right, in you go! Go on, get it sorted out! Go on, get stuck in there!
2 minutes!
Well, hey! They will come off, they're on a hook. Have a look. Have a look at them on the hook.
Jenna, quickly, these walls are coming in, and there's helmets on this wall as well, remember?
Yeah, helmets both sides, make sure we stay on the heads, that's a good thing. Make sure they stay on. Oh, it's good, it works out. Oh,
here.
So there might be a long one there. Oh, so go before you put it on. Not bad. Oh, short one's on. Think about it, Don't rip it off. Don't just smash it to make it work. If you go out with the wrong gate, you lose. That's it, okay? So listen to your team and say, I'll try to guide you. So, are you ready?
Yeah,
we can all see it. Yeah, hi, teams. Welcome back. Now, I ought to give you my name, you know. It's Johnson. Steve Johnson. Codename 00000. Well done, Orange Team. First out of the maze, eh? That gives you the right to decide, you see. In front of me, I have two keys there. One is for Boris's tower, the other is for the nightmare room. Inside that room, there is a task that is worth two eyeballs. So, team, what are you going to do? Are you going to go in there, or are you going to turn that lock in?
We're going in.
You're going in.
The name Spooking's my game, and this is a neat task for the little groovers. Make two towers from the 10 dice lying around, but make sure the symbols match. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Right, in you come. In you come. Step down into the nightmare room. Take your time. Take it easy there. Go on, in you go. In you go. Your time has started. Go on. Place on them squares. Look for those shapes.
Got 2 minutes.
Is it right, though? Is it right? It is right. Make sure you're not building two of the same. The tears. Did you see it, Boris?
Oh, yes, Master. The smell of defeat is in the air.
You're telling me, and you've got 8 of them. Give us the scores, Boris.
Well, Master, I sphinx. The score is none to the oranges and 4 to the green.
Ooh, take those eyeballs and slap them down on your plate there. Absolutely superb. I think a bogeying was in order. Let's have another little challenge. So, Kimberly, tell us all about your chain game and how are you getting on with old Boney?
I tell you, Boney and I have become best friends, haven't we, Uncle Boney? What you have to do is take my best friend off his peg and carry him along this chain over, through and under all the obstacles and hopefully putting him in his coffin at the end. But here is a very, very important warning. If the manacle touches the chain, you will hear this sound. And if we hear that horrible sound more than 3 times or more, the game is over. You have 3 chances or 1 minute to get Boney safely into his coffin. We can hide him. So, Oranges, you will start in 3, 2, 1.
Go! Take it easy.
Good start.
Keep moving. Take it easy. Come. Catch again.
times, they've got one chance left. They get on that one. Come on. Not very long left now. Gotta keep moving. You gotta keep moving. There. You managed to get over two obstacles and were marked up on the chain where you've got. So, green team, are you ready? Well, take it away. You managed to steam on past the orange team, so you are all the winners. I'm sorry about that, orange team, I'm really sorry. But green team, you don't have the chance to decide, because this is the key to the last room, and this is what it is.
Boris's Tower.
Ooh, Boris's Tower. So, tough old decision to make here. Are you going to go in, or are you going to send this little bunch in? What are you going to do? What are you going to do? What are you going to do?
Send them in.
You're going to send them in? Come with me, let's wait! Yes,
yeah. Ooh, here's a sticky task for the tiny terrors. Submerged below me are some of me best spider silk threads. What the oranges have to do is weave them into a web. All it takes is a bit of spit and polish, and they've got 2 minutes. Aren't those threads super? It's amazing what you can do with phlegm, isn't it? Hey?
Right, here you go, here you go. Come on, get down those slides.
Time has started. Look for the colours! Before you start climbing, white, where's white? Have a look at it. It's right up high there. Look, it's right at the top there. Where's blue? Blue's up the other side. Look, have a look for the colours. Don't climb till you've seen them. I think white's on you. That's white you've got there, isn't it?
Yeah.
And where are you taking it? Oh, white's at the top. Come on, you gotta get these high ones in.
Okay.
Right, get down to the next one.
Wrong side.
Lift up the wrong side there, which is a bit of a bad mistake. Come on, we're gonna get a move on. Right, what are you looking for next? Purple, where's purple? It must be here somewhere. Where is it? Just here?
A minute left!
Just go around the thing. What are you looking for now?
You have to weave your wicked web in mine.
That's just a little something of my own.
Give us the scores!
You must remember this. The oranges now have two. The greens still have four.
All right, go down and put them in your soap dish. This is the stinky sink, and in here there are a lot more eyeballs. You've got 2 minutes to find as many as you can and stick them into your soap dishes. Ooh. The one with the most eyeballs at the end is the winner. So teams, get stuck in! Yo-ho-ho! Great, well, I've got this teammate, fantastic. Dig for them, dig for them. Go on, get in there, they're deep. They're in deep, they're not in the top.
No, that's not one.
Dig for them, go down to the bottom. They'll be at the bottom, that's where they are. Cover your eyes. Cover your eyes. Oh, feel for them. That isn't an eyeball. That is not an eyeball.
It's not an eyeball.
Come on, feel for them. Come on, just move it around. Why don't you just pull your eyepiece up a little, and then you'll be able to see. Why don't you just pull your mask up a little there? Buddy bag containing a t-shirt, a mug, a pen, a puzzle, baseball caps, eyeballs, and some prawn crackers. But of course, you won't be able to use your prizes. I mean, in Rebecca's case, you won't even be able to see her prizes because you're going to remain guests here at Tellers forever. bye-bye. Oh, green team, we've all had a laugh, we've all had a bit of fun, but now we're concentrate. You've been playing as a team, now you play as individuals. Now in my book, I've got a poem. I'm going to read you that poem and you're going to see some objects. Then I'm going to ask you 8 questions. The more questions you get right, the better the prize. So please, please remember, see and hear. Are you ready? Are you ready? Okay. Uncle Ebenezer had a yellow glass eye. He dropped it one Friday, toad and ham pie. We stopped the two label for an electric cable, shot through him sideways, straight under the table. For his main course he ate some green moldy bread and a smelly old fish that had passed. For pudding, his favourite, bat and rat jelly, which he ate off plate in front of the telly. He sat quite contented in his long wool nightshirt, drinking hot milk and bull's blood from a mug top of dirt. That night, Ebenezer went off to his bed, but with bad indigestion, he wished he was dead. Ready for answers? I'm going to start with you, Carl. What relation to me was Ebenezer?
Your uncle.
Correct, Gemma. Where did he eat his pudding?
TV.
Correct. What was his favourite food?
Bread and
No. Bat rat jelly. Jem, what did he have for his main course?
The fish and the bread.
Correct. What did he go to bed with? His stomach. Correct, I'll give you that. What sort of pie was it? It's toad and ham pie. What colour was the electric cable?
Red.
Correct. What was he wearing?
Eyeglass, yellow eye.
No, it wasn't. He was wearing a long wool nightshirt. What scores have you got? Well, you've got 5, so your big prize is this!
Rave on!